Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, back to Scrap Mechanics Survival Mode. And as you can see, was just in the middle of some mining off camera, but now I'm on camera, so I've stopped mining so that we can get to the more interesting stuff. I've actually filled up a lot of my resource containers here with how quickly I was able to mine some of the rocks. Credit to, I think, John Bain, who told Khan, who then told me, that you can actually hook up your drills to controllers. And even though, look how slow they spin. Even though they spin this slow, they actually work amazing on a full speed maxed out controller. So the mining process has actually been not too bad. I still get a little bit of like spaghettifying of my bearings and stuff when I get to a rock that's too big. But it was going really, really fast and efficient. To give you an idea here, we still have a full container right there. This one's about halfway. This one looks like it's done. But, oh, my character's running without me pressing the button. But I've done about this much harvesting over here and over here. So hopefully this will get us a decent amount of brick and maybe even, I'm probably gonna mostly put it into brick because I feel like we're gonna be mostly building out of brick. I might build half concrete, so we'll be producing twice as much brick as concrete, but we'll still be producing concrete. Because I think I might want to add some concrete in as well to what we're going to be doing with our base. So if you didn't guess already, we're going to be doing some base building again in this episode. Oh boy, did that, hey, okay, we're good. No, everything's fine. We're all good here. So yeah, it took, you know, maybe like an hour and a half or so for me to collect what I've collected so far. The biggest thing was finding stone. I'm really disappointed that stone, I mean, I obviously in real life, the stone doesn't regenerate once you mine it, but I feel like in survival here, this is not an infinite resource, and it can get destroyed once you've crafted it and put it into your building blocks. You can't repurpose it once you've crafted it in a craft bot into like concrete or brick. So what if you just mined your entire world and there was no stone left and you didn't have what you needed or what you wanted, especially considering it can get destroyed, which means that you could have all the resources that you need, but as soon as you have some raids that end up destroying your resources, you need to replenish them. And if the nodes don't get replenished, then there is actually a finite amount on the world here, which means that you could theoretically run out. But I'm hoping that they plan for that to be a thing in the future where nodes will respawn, because I keep having to go further and further away from my base in order to get some stone and even trees that are good. But we have returned home and we are ready to drop off. Oh boy, that didn't go very well, did it? Come on, get up, get. All right, this isn't working. I'm just gonna use my lift now. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and prioritize the stone out of here. So I hope I got, wow, I actually got a lot of metal. Usually you get way more stone than you get metal, but that's not a whole lot of stone that we have here. But here, let's just fill up this chest with the stone. Let's start it crafting. We're gonna go with brick over here. And then we're gonna add brick over here. And then do we have enough for concrete? I think we need some water. No, we're good. We have enough for concrete. So we're gonna do brick and concrete over here while we're doing just brick over here. So that means we should be producing twice as much brick as we are concrete and still getting a bit of both. All right, there we go, look at that. So this is all the stone I managed to get from like an hour and a half, but I also do have a lot of metal, so that's good too. I'll just go ahead and put all the metal in here, and even I'll just put everything else in here. And we can go ahead and make some wood as well, because we have plenty of scrap wood now. And I'll also make wood over here so we can just get through the wood a little bit faster. All right, so now that we're crafting that, let's see how much brick do I actually already have, because we're going to be needing a lot of brick because we're going to be building up from where we are right now. We're going to be building those towers up. And yeah, we don't have a whole lot left. I did like another hour and a half before the last episode and turned that into as much brick as I could. And that's it. That's all the brick I have. So that's not gonna last us too long, unfortunately. Oh, I should probably feed my glowworms. Are they still here? My glowworms okay? All right, let's go ahead and put that in there. All right, there we go. Glowworms look good. Okay, so if you missed two episodes ago, What we ended up doing, where's my toilet? What we ended up doing was building the ceiling of this place, and then it's kind of dark so you can't really see, and then we started building the framework of this. Now we have two rooms up here that are gonna be two towers, and then those towers are going to converge up there. And actually, I feel like they could convert, they could converge even higher. Ooh, I'm getting some ideas. I don't know yet. I don't know what I wanna do. Let's start building up with these towers though, and just see how it goes. Man, I'm actually a little bit worried. Even with all of the stone that I've gotten over the past couple of hours of mining, I don't think we're gonna have a lot to work with, to be honest. Like, look at this. Look at this. That's already one stack, and it's just gonna keep going like that pretty much. Here. All right, there's another stack. Let's see how fast, let's see how much it takes just to get one more 16 block height out of this. Is that 16? Yeah, that appears to be 16. Okay. And then taking into account everything we do on this tower is going to be doubled by duplicating it onto the other side. All right, there we go. So that took 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 stacks. And now I have 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 left. So we're almost through we're almost through an hour and a half of work right there. That's like 45 minutes of work that you've just witnessed me put into 30 seconds. Oh, I can't believe this. I thought I prepared. Oh my goodness, you gotta be kidding me. I'm out. I'm already all out. Just like that. I have no more left. I put an hour and a half of work into gathering all that. You know, all right, hold on. Go back down. How do I get down? I didn't make there an easy way to go down yet. Okay, we need to not be wasting on concrete right now. I'm done making concrete because apparently we need a lot more brick. How are we doing? All right, we still have over 1,000, so we got that going for us at least. But man, this is resource intensive. I can't believe this. I couldn't even finish one stack or one 16 block height. All right, what about concrete? Do I have concrete somewhere? All right, there's some concrete because I had some plans. Oh yeah, we got a bunch of concrete here. So at least we have this going for us. I can get more brick back by doing what my plan with the concrete was. Did I leave my toilet out here? No. All right, so I'm gonna get some more brick back by making this have a concrete walkway. So this is gonna be more of like the high class level. I mean, this one also has a bit of a rug, but this is gonna be outdoor. This one has an overhang. This is gonna be completely outdoor here. But let me take what little brick I have left and try to finish what I can on this tower first. But I'm gonna put a concrete kind of, I don't know if it's gonna be a rug or it's just gonna be a walkway marker. All right, there we go. Now we have 46 brick left and we've managed to put these up by a couple more blocks. Let's see what it looks like from a distance here. Oh, that doesn't help. Come on, get on top. By the way, I am aware that this is not technically completely symmetrical because this workshop for some reason is even width, but as you can see, the center point is on a single point here that I built this entire spot on. So this is a odd width section and that goes into an even width section. For whatever reason, I thought I made things even, but I'm off by a block, okay? It's not gonna be that noticeable from a distance. Just stop thinking about it, all right? Now that I've said it out loud and it's in all of your minds, just stop thinking about it. What is going on here? Did I mess this up? There's glass on one side, but not on the other. And I don't think I meant for this layer to be here. All right, there we go. All right, I think that looks better. Wait, oh wow, I'm just really inconsistent. I'm seeing inconsistencies everywhere now. Now that I pointed out one inconsistency, seeing them all over the place. Okay, I think we're good now. I think we're all good. All right, this is looking pretty good so far. So here's the plan. I'm gonna go 3 blocks on either side. Like that. So then this becomes concrete. So we have like a concrete walkway like this going all the way around. You think this is gonna look good? I don't know. I honestly don't know what to expect with this. Let's go backwards. It's gonna be easier to measure out going backwards. I think 3 blocks on either side is good. So now look how much brick I'm gonna be getting back. Yeah, this is a good way to diversify resources, I guess you could call it, rather than just single sourcing everything on one resource, which makes it way more intensive. You can diversify by adding a couple different other types of resources in here as well. All right, make sure everything stays 3 blocks from the edges. 1, 2, 3. Okay, I think that makes it consistent. All right, yeah, I'm gonna build this going all the way around. I think this will look nice. Look, I already like how this is looking so far. And then we can even go in from here. 1, 2, 3. I like this. I like already this is starting, like, just adding a little bit of variety in the type of materials that we're using. It's already starting to look great. All right, hopefully we have, this is why I was gonna make more concrete, because I figured that this would also be kind of resource intensive, but I think I really need to prioritize brick right now. So I'm just gonna try to push this concrete as far as I can through the edges here, and we're gonna see how much that leaves us with. And I just replaced that entire thing with brick because I'm a big brain. All right. More concrete is needed. How much more do I even have? Probably not a lot. Did I just use all my concrete already? Did I really just use all of it? Oh no. Please be concrete somewhere that's just hidden. Well, there's one stack. I found one stack of concrete hiding. And I think that's all the concrete we're gonna get. You know what? I'm gonna do it again. Even though I really know we need a lot more brick, I kind of would like to have this concrete as well. Oops, no, keep that going, and then keep that going. So this is how much stone we have left. What is the ratio? 10 to 10. 5 to 10. Oh, you can actually get more concrete with less stone. I knew that, but I forgot and was just reminded. All right, well, we're working with what we got here. So let's continue on. Yeah, we're definitely gonna need a lot more concrete here. Oh, by the way, before we get too far in the episode, I do want to ask you guys again. I asked you before in another episode, but I asked you a lot of questions in an episode, so it was hard to find answers to this particular question. So I want to ask you guys again. We have two rooms here, two towers here. What should the bottoms of these towers, what should the themes of each of these be? Some of you were saying bedroom, maybe? I can see that. Honestly, I was kind of planning on having a bedroom down there. But you know what? Maybe we can have that be like a public area down there, and then up here can be more private area. So one of these can be a bedroom, and that's where we can keep like the dress bot. We can maybe put like a dress, we can put like walls and stuff and have different rooms in here maybe. I don't know. Let me know what you guys think. Bedroom was one of the options I saw, and then maybe we can have like a dining room or something. I don't know. Let me know what you guys think what these two rooms could be. Maybe they're related, maybe they're not related, but we're out of concrete now. So everyone say goodbye to our last little bit of concrete. And of course, we're like one block short to make it even. But from the front, you can kind of see what my plan is here. And then what I'm going to be doing on the edges is I'm going to be using this brick stuff again. What was it? 4 blocks high or 3 blocks high? How many blocks is that? It's like 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 blocks wall total going all the way around. I'm going to build those, I don't know what they're called. The little pillars, the mini pillars that are on the edges. I know you guys told me before, but I have a terrible memory for that kind of stuff. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. All right, so I did the whole front. I left the back open just to conserve some concrete, and we're not really going to be able to see it that much from the front anyway, so it's like a waste for minimal aesthetic purpose or function. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and fill this archway part in. That way we don't have these ugly holes here. There we go. And actually, I'm going to do the same thing I do with the doors, where I'm going to make the archway have an extra layer, like a protrusion. That way it's a little bit more pronounced. I think it just looks better. All right, there we go. How do we like that? I think that looks great. Oh, I got to do the back now. Totally forgot that there's two sides to this thing. All right, there we go. Backside is done. So now let's go ahead and check on our concrete and other crafting materials, concrete and brick. How are we doing here? All right, we got a little bit of concrete, not a whole lot. This is how much brick we've crafted so far. It's pretty slow going. How are we doing on materials? Are we under 1,000 yet? We're still over 1,000 for stone, so that's good. We got some more concrete here. So I'm gonna prioritize the placement of the concrete since that's what we need less of to build right now. So I'm gonna stop building concrete whenever we don't need it anymore. So let's go ahead and continue this walkway as far as we can until we run out of this next batch of concrete. And then we just continue this going until we complete the walkway, and then we stop the concrete production so we can get as much brick as we can. 1, 2, 3. All right, there we go. All right, oh man, we are so close. Look at this. This is all we have left right here. Wait a minute. Oh, did I? What? What? How did I do this wrong? Oh, I confused myself a lot there. Because I put this here. That makes this 2 instead of 3 now. So I think actually, I'm gonna stop the concrete production now. Because I want this to be 3 in from there, and I want it to be 3 in from this side as well. And 3 in from this side. So that actually means if I put this here, that's only gonna be 2 now. So I just made it uneven by adding this wall here without realizing it. So let's go ahead and stop the concrete production because I don't think we actually need any more. That's not doing concrete. All right, there we go. We stopped the concrete. Let's let it do its last batch here. All right, and we'll just grab this last bit out here. And I think we should be able to complete this walkway that we have now because I get to pick up all of this concrete and replace it with more brick. All right, here it is. We have the entire outer walkway now. Now I'm kind of wondering, should I replace the entire inner floor in here with, like, should I replace it with concrete? Or should maybe another material? I don't know. If I want to replace it with concrete, I'm going to have to make a lot more concrete. But here, let's get what brick we have now and see if we can raise all these towers up by at least one more. Oh yeah, look at how much we managed to get now. This is actually going pretty well. Oh, well, this side's not. Oh, because this side was crafting brick and concrete, so it was a little bit slower on the brick. So that makes more sense. Oh, I need more drink. Is Hank still around? Oh yeah, Hank went swimming. I forgot. Okay, there he is. He's trying to get back in. Should I make like a stairway? Would they get up from the water? I don't know if they would actually get up from the water or not, but it looks like we got plenty of milk thanks to Hank that I cannot actually get. Because I have a full inventory right now. So let me drop off. I have fertilizer in my inventory that I don't need. Can drop that off right here. Oh, he's hitting. Hank is hitting. Hank, no. He's breaking his porch. All right, come after me. I might have to. Hank isn't gonna follow me into the water. This is a problem. Hank, I cannot believe you've done this to your own home. I spent so much time building this home for you right here. All right, I honestly don't know if we can get Hank out of this position here. He's kind of stuck. He's also in the dark, so I can't see him. But he's a danger to his own home here because his porch is made out of wood and he wants to try to hit it to get back into his home. I don't know how to get. Oh, wait. Can I? Hank, I'm just trying to lift you up here. I'm trying to be supportive. I just want to support you, okay? Come on, Hank. Just let me give you a lift, bro. Ah! Not like that. All right, you know what? I'm just going to leave him there for now. He's going to take a swim for a little bit. We'll figure out how to deal with Hank later. We got more pressing issues. We have more pressing issues than a drowning friend right now. We have walls to build. All right, so like I said, I'm gonna try to go one more 16 block extension high on both of these towers, and we're gonna see if I've gathered enough materials to at least accomplish that. Uh-oh, I just heard the craft bots stop crafting, which means we are out of stone, and whatever we've managed to craft in our inventory right now down there in our craft chain is all we have. So we're gonna find out very soon just how much all of that work I've done was really, really worth. All right, guys, so here is everything that I had on me. So I have that left and that left. So do we have enough crafted down below to at least fill? Oh, no, I missed the ramp. Do we have enough to at least fill in those last? Oh yeah, we definitely do. We at least have enough to extend these towers up. as high as I wanted to. But that's not a lot left. Like, we're down to the wire here. This is, like, maybe 3 to 4 hours worth of just plain stone mining. And I've managed to extend these up by 2 lengths, pretty much, and put this wall up here that's also not even finished. All right, there we go. That side is closed. And let's go ahead and take care of this one right here. All right, there we go. Now let's check the height from a distance, see what it's looking like. Yeah, I think that's actually good. And you know what we can do? Ooh, I kind of like this idea. We can take the top of that archway. We can actually make that another floor. Oh, no. Because then that means I want to extend these higher again. I don't know. I don't know what to do with this. This is like, we're on a crossroads where you have to make some decisions here. But let me try to explain what's running through my mind right now. So what I'm thinking is putting some doors right here and then having like another floor right here. But then that also means that I need to extend these up because I can't make a floor right here and then a floor right there, you know? Because that's too close compared to what we have down here where we have this huge area. Maybe we do another archway here that is actually identical to that archway. Maybe slightly smaller, not as tall. Or maybe it should be as tall. Because if we do that, we could actually take this wall away and then have this extend out in that direction a bit. So let's delete that and let's pretend that we actually have a walkway potentially going out here. And we could have some interesting stuff. We could have one of those. Oh, you know what I mean? Where they give the announcements, where like the king comes out and then he gives the announcement, although there's really nowhere. Well, I guess we could have people technically out there, because I don't know how that worked back in the day, where you just have one guy standing on this precipice and they had no amplification technology, no speakers or microphones or like megaphones or things like that. And he would just talk to a crowd of like tens of thousands of people who are like thousands of feet away from him. And is anybody other than like the first 10 rows really hearing anything he's saying? Like, especially if anyone is murmuring to each other in the audience, there's no way they could hear anything that they're saying. So if that's really how they gave speeches back in the day, then no wonder they had the term Dark Ages. You just know whatever the king said, only like 20 people actually heard him, and then the rest was all just hearsay and just gets morphed until you get the final person that's like, really? The king said that? Yeah, so that's what this is gonna be. This is gonna be the speech platform. All right, I went ahead and did it. I made another archway, so this is happening now. This is gonna be a thing. So this means at the very least, we need to build these. How tall is this? It's pretty much exactly one more. We need to build these towers one more length high, and then we're gonna have our top middle tower that'll be like the throne room, I guess. Now, I have a lot of second guesses because I feel like the throne room should have easy access to the speech area. Maybe, I don't know. I guess one flight of stairs is all right for the king or queen to have to travel down, right? I say this like I'm building it for some other royalty when this is my world and my castle. I'm the king here. I can decide however I want to build it. If I want to walk down a flight of stairs to give a speech to absolutely nobody, maybe a cow and Hank, who is hopefully, he's okay. He's still over there. If I want to give a speech to Hank, then I can do it after going down a flight of stairs. I'm fine. Okay, let me continue this archway over onto the backside here as well. I guess we can have a back little balcony to overlook the ocean, because this is an amazing view, isn't it? Right into the sun as well. All right, so I had enough brick at least to do front and back side archway foundation. So at least we kind of have a good framework of what we're looking at. So now, how do I want to shape this? I wasn't even expecting to be working on this, to be honest. Like, this is a new development that just kind of naturally arised as I was building. So let me build it out at least one more length. And we are very, very quickly running out. This is our last little bit right here. This is all we have of brick right now. So I do feel like it'll start off here and then it should expand out to the sides a little bit. I feel like it should be kind of round, and round is never fun in Scrap Mechanic. All right, I'm just gonna do some improvisational architectural building here, and we're just gonna see what happens and how it looks after I'm done with it. I have no idea what's gonna happen, but it's getting dark, so hey, If it's terrible, I won't even be able to see it anyway. Alright guys, so I've finished designing the foundation of the speech platform, and it's a little bit weird. Like I said, I was improvising things, and I figured to give it a little bit more context, I'm going to take some of the metal. Now, as I was building this platform, I actually ran out of brick, so I actually had to steal some from up here by extending this concrete section in a little bit and replacing the brick here so I could get some of that brick back. So here it is from underneath, and here, let's get on up here if I can. There we go. So here's what I'm thinking. So it kind of expands out onto a circular or a roundish, ovalish platform. And then these three little prongs here, this is why I need to add some rails for context. So let's go ahead and let's add railing right here. I guess three high is good for a rail. So as I put this rail in, I think it's going to kind of really put into perspective what my intent is here for this kind of... I'm sure that there's an official, very fancy name for this kind of structure where the person comes out from the castle to give speeches and tell all the people how great of a king they are and how amazing everything that they're doing is for their kingdom. So yeah, check it out. So there's gonna be, this is where the main speech person stands, and then of course they can have some like supporters here, maybe the queen or like the right-hand man or whoever's in charge of their military forces. You know, they can be on the sides to be there for support. And then let me go ahead and just add this rail going all the way around so we can kind of contextualize the whole shape of the thing. All right, there we go. This is a really odd shape. It looks like a dog paw. That's what it looks like. It looks like just a paw from some type of cute critter. You know, I'll take it. I feel like I might almost want to make this not even a railing and make it just solid. Like, you know, like this all the way through. I actually feel like that'll look nice. Hey, let's do that real quick. All right, and here we are. Here, let's put our toilet down. Our throne right here. And here we give our speech to our loyal sub... Nobody showed up. I should build like a bunch of fake people out there just to pretend like I'm actually giving a speech to somebody. But I think this is looking pretty good. Here, let's go ahead and step back, take a look from a distance and see what it's... Oh boy, that's a long way down. Ow. I'm fine. I'm fine. It's just a scratch. Just a few broken bones. All right. Wow. Look at that. Just in time for the sun to set. But I think this is starting to take shape. Just imagine now those towers go up just a little bit higher and we cap them off. Just like we did before, and then we will add our final singular tower going up where we can put the throne or whatever. I think this is coming along really, really nicely. There's some type of inconsistency up there that I'm seeing. Is that a lighting thing? What is that? Oh, I actually missed a spot up there. All right, I'll have to remember to fill that in. But I think this is coming along nicely. All right, I hope you guys enjoyed this. Don't forget to leave comments down below on what you want these two separate rooms to be. And also, don't forget to check out the merch store if you want to see some cool merch to help support the channel. We got your diamond plate face mask if you want a cool custom face mask. And also, we get other types of shirts and things on there as well. Looking forward to your feedback as always. If you want to see more awesome content on the channel, go ahead and check out the end screen right here. Hope this video has earned your subscription. Anyway, this has been Scrapman, and I'll see you next time. Bye!